Hello students, this is Ajit Dave from Platform of Sinhals. Students, today we'll be doing certain good problems. Those problems which most of the students feel so that they are slightly tricky, or maybe they are not able to recollect, or maybe able to connect it with respect to one chapter with respect to the second chapter. And these questions will be certainly based on your JE mains as well as from the NEET also. Of course, these questions, many students must have gone through it in these particular 2 years of time. But since you have your upcoming exams very soon, I want you all to work out with these particular basic questions, and one has to do very sincerely with this so that you'll be able to get maximum output of it. The scoring what you're getting it should be slightly graded much more better. It should be slightly more. And that is only possible when you crack certain good questions based on your GE as well as from NEET. Today we'll be having a slightly a mixed concept related to both these particular questions, either from JL pickup as well as from NEET also I'll be trying to pick up. But at the same time, the student should be able to tackle with these questions very, very easily. So listen to me very carefully, students. Whatever I'm speaking also, listen carefully, observe properly. If possible, try to note down the important points also, students. This will really, really help you out for your exams. And at the end of it, I want you all to certainly go for subscription for it, as well as liking it also, and do pass on comments, students. So let's start off with physics for JE we consider. To start off with, students, let us go for first a basic question related to electrostats. Now, since I'm picking up this particular chapter, electrostats, students, that is, let me speak about a certain questions related to it. The questions, if I happen to consider, is the time when I speak about for this question is, suppose if I happen to speak about an uncharged spherical conductor, students, hope you are able to get the diagram very proper. What exactly, students, I've taken is, I've taken an uncharged spherical conductor, students, is that clear? Which is along, we consider the z-axis, we consider. So I've taken an infinitely long thin non-conducting wire. And what am I trying to do? I'm keeping this particular wire parallel to the z-axis, students, which carries a uniform line charge density lambda. Let me put forward this particular question, student, and then we'll try to work onto it. Okay, students. Now listen carefully, students. I've written a question for y'all. Now it's a question related to electrostatics. And many of the students must be knowing the basics of electrostatics in this case. But I'll just read out the question for y'all, and hope that you will be able to solve and try to crack it and try to think what exactly the solution of this is. If you happen to look at the question, what exactly question I've given to you, students? I've given you, and that's an infinitely long thin non-conducting wire, students. Please, it's an infinitely. That means the wire is made to move on either side, plus infinity to minus infinity. Okay, and non-conducting wire, okay, is parallel to the z-axis. Now this is a z-axis we consider, and carries a uniform line charge density lambda, students. So uniform charge density, what exactly consider? Lambda, students. That means what exactly I'm trying to consider, that I've taken an infinitely long non-conducting wire, yani pura ek lamba sa wire hai aur usko pura electrically charge karke rakha hua, uniform line charge density, but it's infinitely long. And it is parallel to which axis? Z-axis. लेकिन ये जो वायर है क्या किया मैंने? सर ये वायर को मैंने पियर्स करके रखा है. So please highlight important terms also while solving questions related to it. It pierces a thin non-conducting spherical shell. Please, it's a non-conducting spherical shell. Let us see, this is the center of the shell I'll consider. Now if I happen to look over here, it pierces a thin non-conducting spherical shell of radius capital R. Means if I happen to consider this is a spherical shell, I'll take this capital R as a radius of this particular shell. In such a way that arc PQ subtends an angle of 120 degrees at the center O. That means now if I happen to consider, I need to show the charged infinitely long charged wire, students. Now have a look at it, students, please. It's an infinitely long charged wire. What about point PQ they're trying to go? Please, this particular point PQ we consider as an arc. Can I call PQ to be as a chord of the same circle we consider? Yes. Is this particular thin wire we consider uniform line charge density? It has a charge onto it. And what exactly the charge per unit length we consider? That is lambda. What is lambda we consider? It's simply called as linear charge density, students. What is linear charge density I'll consider will be? So simply I can consider is what? So it's Q by L. That is what exactly? It's charged per unit length we consider. So now when I speak about it, so I've taken an infinitely long charged uniform wire. The word uniform stands for, that is the mass is uniformly distributed and the charge is also uniformly distributed throughout its length, students. Ye jo wire hai wo pierce karke rakha hua hai kahan pe? X spherical shell ke andar. Radius kya hai? Capital R hai. Abhi jo points PQ hai wo kya karte hai? Sir, they subtend an arc. Please wait, students. This particular subtends an arc of how much? It subtends an arc of 120 degrees. Where? At the center of the circle we consider. Now when you carefully look into it, students, what exactly this is? So this is radius of the circle. Agreed? What is this angle I'll consider? So this is 120 degrees, students. Now if I want to find out what exactly it is, which of the following statement is true or are true? That means it can be one or more than one option correct, students. Let us solve this particular question. So to start off with, what exactly I'll consider? Sir, you have given me theta is 120 degrees, we have got it. PQ is an arc of the circle. Can you get a relation? The answer is in our students. Can you get a relation of this particular angle with respect to the length of arc and the chord? So what do you do? So if I happen to drop a perpendicular over here, means can I say, I'm trying to consider a simple right angle triangle. And the basics, all of you all are aware about it. A perpendicular drawn from the center of the circle to the chord bisects the chord, students. So this will be 60 degrees. Agreed. Now first of all, let us go for triangle. I'll put the triangle over here. What exactly triangle you consider? So let us go for triangle PMO, students. What about angle POQ is an entire 120 degrees. So this will be 60 degrees. What is this PO we consider? So it's a radius of the circle. That is radius of the spherical shell, students. Of radius capital R we consider, which is non-conducting, and a uniformly charged infinitely long wire is pierced through it, students. Tumhe pucha gaya hai option A, option B, option C, option D. Which one out of it is or are true we consider? That means I can have either one or more than one option. So let us go for, first of all, your linear charge density. Lambda is equal to what? Q by L we consider. Now when I speak about it, what exactly the length I'll consider will be? So the length will be what? Length yahan pe kya hoga? So length infinitely, the answer suna students, infinitely long charged wire ke baare mein baat kar raha hu. To length kya pakadoge aap? Length kya pakadoge? Ha sir, length to chord hoga PQ. So can I say this length is nothing but I can consider simply PQ? Yes, I can take that. Now if I happen to consider my relation for sine of 60 degrees for this right angle triangle, what exactly sine of 60 degrees we consider is? So sine of 60 degrees is equal to what? So it's opposite side upon hypotenuse, means can I say it's PM upon PO, students. What is sine of 60 we consider is? So it's root 3 by 2. What is PM? What is PM? So PM is half of PQ. Me students, the answer soon now. What is PM? What is PM, students? So PM is equal to half of PQ. Reason kya hai? A perpendicular drawn from the center of the circle to the chord bisects the chord, students. So now instead of PM, students, instead of PM, can I write down this in terms of what exactly write on PQ by 2? So yahan pe kya likhu main? So this is PQ upon twice into PO. What does PO stands for? Radius of the circle. Hope this part is clear with the students. So when you go for this particular question, try to understand what exactly the question is speaking about. They have taken a certain spherical shell which is non-conducting. ओके उसमें से क्या किया उन्होंने एक वायर को पियर्स किया जो इन्फाइनाइटली लॉन्ग है और वो इलेक्ट्रिकली चार्ज है यूनिफॉर्मली चार्ज व्हाट एक्जैक्टली लीनियर चार्ज डेंसिटी फॉर दिस सो इट्स क्यू बाई एल लेंथ क्या लोगे सो जो जो वायर इस टू एंड्स के ऊपर दैट इज व्हाट इट्स इंटरसेक्टिंग दिस पर्टिकुलर स्फेरिकल शेल एट पॉइंट पी एंड क्यू एल कंसीडर दैट बिकम्स माई लेंथ सो द लेंथ इज पी क्यू स्टूडेंट्स नाउ व्हेन यू मूव फर्दर अहेड व्हाट एम आई गेटिंग द वैल्यू ऑफ पी क्यू सो टू एंड टू विल गेट कैंसिल देयरफॉर व्हाट एक्जैक्टली पी क्यू PQ क्या होगा सो दिस इज रूट थ्री बाई इंटू कैपिटल आर वी कंसिडर ऑफकोर्स दैट्स वॉट वी कंसिडर नाउ व्हेन अ स्टूडेंट इज लुकिंग इन टू इट द आंसर सुन स्टूडेंट्स हाँ रूट थ्री इंटू कैपिटल आर ऑप्शंस क्या दिया है ऑप्शंस क्या दिया है विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग स्टेटमेंट इज और आर ट्रू नाउ हैव लुक एट द ऑप्शंस द इलेक्ट्रिक फ्लक्स थ्रू द शेल रूट थ्री कैपिटल आर लैम्डा बाई एप्सिलॉन जीरो व्हाट इज एप्सिलॉन जीरो स्टूडेंट्स वी कंसिडर इट्स परमिटिविटी ऑफ फ्री स्पेस As if we consider mu zero, it's permeability of free space students. And there's a strong interlink between students, electric field and magnetic field. Shayad tum log ne kiya hoga? Are haan sir, c, small c is equal to 1 upon under root mu zero into epsilon zero. Mu zero kya tha? Permeability of free space. Epsilon zero kya hai? Permeability of free space. Are haan yaar, mu zero aur epsilon zero agar main dal deta uski values, And if I happen to solve it, I'll get the answer as 3 into 10 to the power of 8 meter per second. Arre, ye toh speed of light in vacuum ho gaya. Yes, that means there is a strong interlink between electric field and magnetic field. Yahan pe hume kya chahiye? See the first option they've given you, electric flux of the shell. That's the first option. Second option kya hai? The Z component of the electric field is zero at all the points on the surface, students. Option C kya diya hai? Option C, what exactly students is given to you? The electric flux of the shell is how much they're given to you? Root 2. Root 2 capital R L capital R lambda upon epsilon 0. I'll put forward this again. It's root 2 capital R lambda upon epsilon 0. Okay, that's the fun. And the electric field is normal, students. What exactly is given to you? Normal to the surface of the shell at all points. Now, when all these particular four options are given to you, and students, you have landed up to this. Most of the students who are listening to me carefully or who are watching this particular video instantly say the answer is what? Sir, option A. How do you consider? Sir, root 3 is coming into it. Capital R is also coming into it. Aur pucha kya tumhe? Electric flux. What exactly are you telling me to find out? Electric flux. How do you put in terms of electric flux? How do you find out electric flux we consider? The total electric flux enclosed by the surface we consider is what? It's 1 upon epsilon times we consider that means what exactly consider it's lambda is equal to what q by l we consider are you getting it so now if I happen to consider with respect to your electric flux then electric flux will be equal to what so root 3 capital R lambda upon epsilon 0 we consider so that's one part second part we consider is what the z component of electric field is zero now if you happen to look into it students see the z component how are the charges so the charges are uniformly distributed students please throughout the charges are uniformly distributed agar suppose main baat karta hu electric field ka agar suppose ye tumhara charge conductor hai aur ye positive charge hai to can I say these are the lines of forces these are the electric lines of forces how the electric lines of forces are originated normally students they are all originated normally ye kaun sa axis tha sir ye z axis tha ये जो स्फीयर का जो लाइन सेंटर से पास हो रहा है दैट इज ऑल्सो पासिंग थ्रू वॉट सो इट्स जेड बिकॉज दीज टू आर वॉट पैरेलल टू ईच अदर नाउ केयरफुली लुक एट द ऑप्शन बी द जेड कंपोनेंट ऑफ द इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड द जेड कंपोनेंट ऑफ द इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड इज जीरो एट ऑल पॉइंट्स नाउ चेक आउट ओवर हियर इज दिस इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड इंटेंसिटी फॉर यूनिफॉर्मली चार्ज्ड लीनियर डेंसिटी वायर वी कंसिडर is it along the z component or it's perpendicular to it it's perpendicular we consider so do we have any z component of electric field no the z component of electric field is simply we consider as zero so now if I happen to consider the total electric flux we consider is okay the total charge please pay attention the total charge enclosed into the surface what exactly we consider will be please since we consider is root 3 into r into lambda because what exactly lambda is equal to q by l we consider is that clear what exactly consider root 3 into r we consider because that's the length of pq so I'll substitute this electric flux what is total electric flux students what is total electric flux total electric flux students hai kya please it's 1 upon epsilon zero the total charge enclosed in that particular surface we consider. ये क्या है सर? ये एक restatement है for Gauss's theorem. One of the statement is the total normal electric induction over a closed surface is the algebraic sum of the net charge enclosed by that particular surface. यानी summation of Q आ जाता है वहाँ पे. दूसरा क्या है? The total electric flux is equal to students 1 upon epsilon times the net charge enclosed sir. So now अगर किसी को total electric flux चाहिए था ये तुम्हारा formula आ गया. ये कहाँ से मैंने लिया है सर? ये तो Gauss's theorem का है और ये हम यहाँ पे यूज़ करेंगे. What is the total charge? सर टोटल चार्ज कितना होगा? सर Q is equal to root 3 times R into lambda. ये कहाँ से आया? सर Q is equal to lambda into L. L क्या था? PQ है. PQ what you've got it? Root 3 into R. Now can I substitute back over here? So now what's the answer? 1 upon epsilon 0 students. What exactly it is? Total charge. What exactly total charge I consider will be? Root 3 into capital R. Into what exactly? Lambda. Have a look at this and have a look at option A. So this is a simple and a basic question which most of the students can easily crack it, but somewhere you need to think. Now the points over here you need to keep in mind is that it's a uniformly charged wire we consider. That means the charge is uniformly distributed. It's an infinitely long conductor we consider. The electric field lines are always perpendicular. So now if I happen to consider this particular charged infinitely long wire and the axis of the spherical shell, how are these two? So both of them are parallel to each other. So electric field kaun se direction hoga? Sir, perpendicular to the surface. I'll consider. Look at the lines of forces. These are all the electric lines of forces. All these electric lines of forces. All these electric lines of forces we consider. So now, do you find electric field lines of forces along the Z component? No, it's not along the Z axis. That is why we went for option B. The Z component of electric field is zero at all points on the surface, students. So this is a simple concept related to your electrostats. Let us go on to the next question. Hope you are able to get this particular question properly, students. Let's go for the next question, okay? Okay, students. The first question was based on the electrostats and it was based on two concepts related to your electric flux. Okay, and it was your concept related to electric field intensity, students. Now we go for a simple question related to your current electricity. Let's see how many of y'all can think onto it and try to get the answer exactly equivalent to me we consider. Let me put forward the question to you all, students. This is a small circuit diagram, students, I'm giving it to you. If you look over here, this is point A. We have a resistor and another point B I'll consider having a resistor. Now this particular resistor is of 2 ohms. This resistor I'll consider with 4 ohms we consider. Now these particular two resistors are connected at point C by another resistance which is of 2 ohms, a switch. Now look at the other end of the switch, students. The other end of the switch I have grounded, students. That means it's at zero potential we consider. That's my switch we consider. Now over here we need to see into it. It said that point A is at high potential we consider and its potential at point A is 20 volts, students. And the potential at point B, students, it's 10 volts. This is 20 volts, students, and this is 10 volts, students, we consider. Okay, so once again I'll speak about it. You have point A at 20 volt, point B at 10 volt potential we consider. If you look over here, this point of the switch we consider is connected to the ground, we take it. The question asked us find out the current. Listen carefully, students, find out the current flowing through this particular 2 ohm resistor we consider, given to you that the current flowing through the resistor 2 ohm is I1, current flowing through the resistor 4 ohm is I2, students. I need to find out the current flowing through this, but when the switch is closed. So, pehla switch open tha. Again, just when the switch closed kiya, let us say that the current flowing over here is I1, the current flowing over here is I2. I want to find out the current flowing through this particular 2-ohm resistor. Let us understand this particular question, students. Now, to understand this particular question, students, first of all, switch is closed. Yes. The answer is no, students. What is this? Zero potential. That means C will be at a certain potential. मेरे को चाहिए क्या? सर मेरे को करंट चाहिए. कैसे मिलेगा करंट? अरे रेजिस्टेंस हमारे हाथ में है. किसी भी हालत में अगर इन दोनों के बीच में मुझे पोटेंशियल डिफरेंस मिल गया, ऑफ कोर्स आई कैन फाइंड आउट द करंट, बिकॉज स्टूडेंट्स ऑल ऑफ यू विल नो इट. करंट ऑलवेज फ्लोज बिकॉज ऑफ डिफरेंस इन पोटेंशियल. करंट नेवर फ्लोज बिकॉज ऑफ अ पोटेंशियल. इट नीड्स अ पोटेंशियल डिफरेंस फॉर इट टू प्रोपगेट आउट टू ट्रैवल. वी कंसिडर. Let us say that the current in the first case they've given to us I1 through 2 ohm, I2 to what? That is to 4 ohm. We consider now what happens when these two currents reaches at point C. What happens in that case? Are ye to junction law hua. Which law we consider? So it's a Kirchhoff's law. We consider which law? We consider, so it's a current law. Of course we have Kirchhoff's first law, we consider as current law. Kirchhoff's second law we consider is what? That is voltage law, the mesh law we consider. Now, if I ask you current law, that is Kirchhoff's first law is current law, does it obey law of conservation of electric charge? Law of conservation of electric charge, students? Are ha yaar, charges do not accumulate at the junction. As many charges approaching the junction, exactly that many charges per unit time will certainly leave the junction, students. So there is no accumulation of charges at point C. That means if I happen to consider the current from here will move, and the current from here will move, and the net current over here will be I. So what exactly my Kirchhoff's law, I is equal to what? So it's I1 plus I2. Does it obey law of conservation? Law of conservation of electric charge? Yes, it will certainly obey law of conservation of electric charge, students. I need to find out this capital I, students. What is the potential? Suppose agar yahan pe maine point A diya, B diya, C diya. Let us take this particular point D. Point B ko kya lunga? Sir, ye grounded hai. That means the other end is connected, buried into the earth. It's at what potential? So it's at zero potential, we consider. Now if I want to speak about the current flowing through it, yes, I'm going to use this mathematical relation. What exactly simple mathematical relation? Once when you get this, many of the students who are listening right now instantly will be able to crack it. Are yaar, ye to easy ho gaya. Current diya hai, current pucha gaya hai. I ka formula kya hai? See, yahan pe to simple, I'll use Ohm's law. What exactly consider is, so delta V is equal to what? Delta V we consider upon delta V is equal to what? Delta I into R. So can I say delta V by R will be equal to delta I we consider? That means difference in potential will be equal to the current flowing through it. Yes, simply I'll be using Ohm's law. So now once when I use Ohm's law, what exactly I'll consider? Sir, yahan pe the total current flowing over will be what? Sir, difference in the potential. The answer dekha students. And ye kya hoga? So VC minus VD hoga. Agreed? Ye hoga difference in potential. Agreed? Upon what? The resistance. What is the resistance over here? It's 2 ohms. Formula kya liya tha? Please, the formula was V R Indians. V is equal to R into I. Okay, so I'm concerned with what? That is V by R is equal to I. I'm using this relation. Yahan pe kya hoga? Sir, I1 ke liye kya hoga? Sir, agar ye I1 le to dhyan se dekhna students. Point A I'll consider to be at high potential. I'll consider point C in comparison to be at low potential. Difference in potential, that is VA minus VC upon the resistance we consider, will be the current flowing I1 through it. And the current is how much? 2 ohms I've given to you. Likewise, if you go for the third one, what is I2 I'll consider? Sir, yahan pe bhi kya hoga? Sir, ye high potential pe hai. In comparison to this, ye kya hoga? Low potential pe. But if I compare C with respect to D, C is at high potential and D will be at low potential. This is very important for a student to understand. Because the flow of current is always due to the difference in potential, student. That's why I said VB is greater than VC. Yahan se current ja raha hai, VA is greater than VC, students. Now when I look into it plus, what exactly? I2 ko kaise lukoge? So it's VB minus VC. Upon what exactly consider? So that's 4 ohms we consider. Now if I happen to solve it, what exactly? Cancellation will be there. 2 is a common factor in all the cases. So what exactly get it? So it's VC minus VB is equal to VA minus VC plus VB minus VC by 2. Look at the potential at point B. So potential at point B is 0. So what do I consider? Sir, isko main 0 le leta hoon. VC mujhe chahiye. Ye hoga 0. How much is VA? Sir, VA is 20. minus VC, I don't know, plus how much is VB? 10 minus VC by 2. This is by 1. This is by 1. Now can I solve further and get the answer? Now see, it becomes much more easier. So what do I consider? If I happen to take it, what exactly? So this is 2 VC is equal to 40 minus 2 VC plus 10 minus VC. 2 into 4 will be how much? That is 4. 4 plus 1 will be how much? 5 VC will be equal to how much? 50. Therefore, what exactly the potential at point C kitna hoga? 50 by 5, that means how much? So 10 volt. Pucha kya hai tumhe? Pucha hai current. Tumhe iska voltage mila. Kitna mila? 10 volt. Agar suppose yahan pe agar ye 10 volt hai, ye 0 volt hai, to in dono ke piche potential difference kitna hua? 10 volt hua. V, haan sir, V hamare haath mein. R, sir, R hamare haath mein. Pucha kya hai? I. So can I say 10 is equal to 2 into I. What's your answer? 5 ampere. So what's the total current flowing? Please, the total current will be equal to how much? 5 ampere, students. Hope this part is clear with the students. So please, when such kind of questions are getting it, to solve it, yes, you need to use your Kirchhoff's laws. Because see, Ohm's law can be used for simple circuits, but when you go for complicated circuits, yes, you need to go for Kirchhoff's law in that case. Whereas over here, I'm using your current law we consider, and that is law of conservation of electric charge. In the first case, VA is greater than VC. Over here, VB is greater than VC. But when I compare with C and D, VC is greater than VD. And the difference in potential causes the current to flow when the switch is closed. So what's the answer for this? 5 amperes. Of course, I didn't speak out the options. The options that had given us 5 amperes, 12.5 amperes, 10 amperes, and 17.5 amperes, students. So the answer is how much? We get it as 5 amperes, students. Hope you must have understood. Of course, it was a short video we consider. And this particular short video, hopefully, I feel like that will be helping it out in that case. But further ahead, students, if in case you feel that, yes, things are really good enough, you're able to catch me very properly, you're able to understand properly, yes, we'll be going with respect to good topics. Topics related to your KTG, thermodynamics we consider, ray optics we consider, because these are the topics which have maximum weightage in your examination, students. So most probably we are trying to work out with short videos of the entire physics syllabus of your class 11th and 12th for your GE mains and NEET separately. Of course, the GE and the NEET will be certainly separately in that case. We'll be working out with it. Hopefully that is, I feel that maximum students will start to subscribe it, enjoy it, like it in that case. At the same time, I want you to pass on comments with respect to it. Wish you all the best. God bless y'all. Take care. Okay? See you soon.